Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Math School Learn to Succeed. In this channel, I'll be teaching you Karnataka Board Class 10th SLC NCERT Math. In today's video, let us solve the question number 3, part 1 from exercise 1.3, chapter number 1, Arithmetic Progressions. In my previous videos, I have solved the question number 1 and 2. If you have not watched that video, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. So before we begin our video today, please like and share my video and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos. In today's video, let us solve the question number 3 from exercise 1.3. In an AP, they have given us different conditions and we have to find out either N, Sn or whatever they have asked. There are 10 parts of the question here. In today's video, we will be solving the first 5 questions of the question number 3. So if you observe the question, they have given us certain values like A, D, A, N, and they are asking us to find the N and Sn value, or they are asking us to find A and S12 value, or they are asking us to find the first term A and the sum of 12 terms. Similarly, all these questions are in the same way. So to solve this question, we have to know the 3 formulas which we have already discussed in my previous videos. That is the nth term formula, which is given by an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, and the sum formula, which is given by Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. If the L, that is the last term, is given, then we can use another formula instead of this, that is Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus n. And also this formula is much easier to solve than the previous one. Okay, if the last term is given, we will be using this formula, else we will be using this formula. So these 3 are the important formulas which you must know before solving these questions. So let us see the first part of the question number 3, where A value is given, that is A is equal to 5, D is given, that is 3, and An is given, that is 50. Now they are asking us to find the N value and the sum Sn we have to find out. By using the nth term formula, we will substitute this n term and find out the n value. So let us take the nth term formula, which is given by An is equal to A plus n minus 1 into d. So we know the a value and we know the d value. We can find out n value easily using this formula. So let us substitute these values and find out here. So nth term is given by 50 is equal to, the first term is 5 plus n minus 1 into d is again 3. So 50 is equal to 5 plus 3n minus 3. Or 50 is equal to, what is 5 minus 3? It is 2 plus 3n. Sending this 2 to the left hand side, we get 50 minus 2 is equal to 3n. Or it is 48 is equal to 3n. Or n is equal to 48 divided by 3. So 3 1 times, 3 1 times, carry 1. 3 6 are 18. Okay, so therefore n value we got here as 16. Now using this n value, we will find out the sum. So let us write down the formula first. Sn is equal to n divided by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. We can also use this formula also, that is Sn is equal to n divided by 2, a plus l, where the last term is nothing but our nth term, that is equal to 50. So either of the two formulas we can use. So let us use last term formula only. So Sn we have to find out for 16 terms. N is 16 divided by 2, A value is 5 plus L is 50. So we get 16 divided by 2 is 2, 1 times 2, 8s are 16. So 8 into 5 plus 50 is 55, or multiplying this value 8. So 8 5s are 40, 8 5s are 40 plus 4, it is 40. 4. Therefore, the sum of the first 16 terms is 440 with n is equal to 16. Therefore, we got n is equal to 16 and Sn is equal to 440. So similarly, let us solve the second part of the question number 3. Here, what is given? A value is given, that is 7. Then a 13th term is given, that is 35. And we have to find out the d value and S13, the sum of 13 terms. So let us use the nth term formula, that is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. 8/13th term is given where the n value will be equal to 13, and we know the first term a, we know the 13th term that is equal to 35, so we can substitute these values and find out the d value. So if we put n is equal to 13, we will get a13 is equal to, what is a value? 7 plus 13 minus 1 into d. So we know the a13th value, that is 35, is equal to 7 plus 12d. So sending this 7 to the left hand side, we get 35 minus 7 is equal to 12d, or 28 is equal to 12d, or d is equal to 28 divided by 12. D is equal to 28 divided by 12. So 2 6s are, 2 1s are, 2 4s are, or 2 3s are, 2 7s are. So we got d value is equal to 7 divided by 3. Now we will find out the sum of 13 terms by using the formula of the sum, which is given by Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So we know the n value, that is equal to S13 is equal to 13 divided by 2 into 2 into a is 7, plus n is 13 minus 1 into d is 7 divided by 3. 13 by 2 into 7 2s are 14, plus 13 minus 1 is 12 into 7 divided by 3. So 3 1s are, 3 4s are. Okay, so this will be 13 divided by 2, 14 plus, what is 7 4s are? 28. So what is 28 plus 14? We will get 13 by 2 into 8 plus 4 is 12, carry 1, 2 plus 1 is 3, 4, it is 42. So 2 1 times, 2 2s are, 2 1s are. So what is 13 into 21? 1 3s are 3, 1 1s are 1, into 3 2s are 6, 2 1s are 2. So 3 7 2. So it is 273. Therefore, S13 is equal to 273, where D is equal to 7 by 3. So this is the result. So coming to the third part of the question number 3, where the 12th term is given, 37, and D value is 3, which is given, and we have to find out the first term A and the sum of the 12 terms. So we can find out the A value by using the nth term formula, which is given by A is equal to, An is equal to A plus, as the 12th term is given. So we will substitute N is equal to 12, and also will substitute D is equal to 3. So A12 is equal to A plus 12 minus 1 into D is 3. So A12th term is what? 37 is equal to A plus 11 into 3, or 37 is equal to A plus 33, or A is equal to, if we transfer this 33 to the left hand side, we will get 37 minus 33, or A is equal to 4. Now we will find out the sum of 12 terms by using the values we have got here. We know that A is equal to 4, the first term, N is equal to 12, and the 12th term is equal to 37, which is nothing but the last term of the AP. Therefore, L is equal to 37. So therefore, we can use the formula Sn is equal to N by 2 into A plus L, since the last term is given. Now we will substitute the values. So sum of 12 terms is equal to 12 divided by 2 into A is 4 plus 37. So this is 2 1 times, 2 6 times. So 6 into what is 37 plus 4? It is nothing but 41. So now multiplying these two values, 6 1s are 6, 6 4s are 24. So therefore S12 is equal to 246, A equal to 4. So this is the result. So coming to the fourth part of the question number 3, here they have given us A3 value, that is the third term, that is 15, and the sum of 10 terms is equal to 125, and they have asked us to find out the D value and A10 value. Okay, here if you notice, they have not given us either the A value or the D value. Let us first assume, let the first term and D be the common difference of the AP. If they have not given us, we have to write down, let A be the first term and D be the common difference of the AP. So now they have given us the third term A3 is equal to 15. So we will use the nth term formula and make the equation AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So here we know the N value is equal to 3 since this is the third term. So we will substitute N is equal to 3 in this equation. So A3 is equal to A plus 3 minus 1 into D. What is A3 value? That is 15 is equal to A plus 2D. So let this be our equation 1. And also what they have given us? They have given us that the sum of 10 terms is equal to 125. So again we will use the formula of the sum, which is given by Sn is equal to N divided by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. We are using this formula since the nth term is not given. If they have given the nth term is nothing but the last term. Then we will use Sn is equal to N by 2 into A plus L. Since the 10th term's sum is given, so N is equal to 10. So substitute this in the formula. So S10 is equal to 10 divided by 2 into 2A plus 10 minus 1 into D. What is S10? S10 is 125. This will be 2 1 times, 2 5 times. So 5 into 2a plus 9d. So let us bring this 5 to the left hand side. You will get 125 divided by 5 is equal to 2a plus 9d. Or this will be 5 1 times. 5 2s are 10 and 5 5s are. So 5 25 times. So 5 is equal to 2a plus 9d. So let this be equation number 2. If you observe the equation number 1 and equation number 2, the coefficient of a here it is 1, whereas here it is 2. So to make it equal, let us multiply the equation number 1 with 2. So 15 into 2 it is 30 is equal to 2. So 2 into 15 is 30 equal to 2a plus 4d. Let this be our new equation number 1. Now we will apply elimination method to equation number 1 and 2 and we will find out the A and D value. So let us apply elimination method to equation 1 and 2. 30 is equal to 2A plus 4D and 25 is equal to 2A plus 9D. So let us change the signs. So this will be minus. This will be plus and plus, so this is minus, term will get cancelled. So again if you change the sign here, the greater number sign will come, and subtracting 9 minus 4 it is 5d is equal to, again here the greater number sign will come, so 30 minus 25 is 5, therefore d is equal to minus 1. Okay, so we got the d value. Now let us substitute the d value in equation 1 and find out the a value. Therefore, we have 30 is equal to 2 into A plus 4 into D is minus 1. So 30 is equal to 2A minus 4. Or if we transfer the minus 4 to the left hand side, we will get 30 plus 4 is equal to 2A. Or 2A is equal to 34. Or A is equal to 34 divided by 2. That will be 2 1 times 2 7. So A is equal to 17. So we know the A value and the D value. Now we can find out the A10 value by using the n term formula, where An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Now here the N value is equal to 10. So A10 is equal to, what is the A value we got? 17 plus N is 10 minus 1 into D is minus 1. So we will get 17 plus 10 minus 1 is 9 into minus 1 is minus 9. So what is 17 minus 9? This is equal to 8. Therefore we got the 10th term A10 is equal to 8 with D value equal to minus 1. Okay, so this is the result. So let us solve the fifth part of the question, where D is given, D equal to 5 and S9 is 75. They are asking us to find out the first term A and the 9th term of the AP. So since sum of 9 terms is given, let us use the sum formula. Sn is equal to n divided by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Since S9 value is given, n value will be equal to 9. So substituting, S9 is equal to 9 divided by 2 into 2a plus n is 9 minus 1 into d is. So what is S9? It is 75 is equal to 9 divided by 2 into 2a. 9 minus 1 is 8. So 8 5s are 40. Or transferring this 9 by 2 to the left hand side, terms will be reversed. It will be 2 by 9 is equal to 2a plus 4. 3 3s are 3, 2s are 6. Carry 1, so 3 5s are 15. So 25 into 2, it is 50 divided by 3. If we transfer this 40 to the left hand side, we will get minus 40 is equals to 2a. So taking the LCM as 3, so 50 minus 4 3s are 12, that is 120 equal to 2a. Or what is 50 minus 120? This 70 divided by 3 is equal to 2a. Or if we send the 2 to the left hand side, we will get 70 divided by 3 into 1 by 2. So 2 1 times, 2 3s are 6, 2 5s are 10. So we will get a is equal to 35 divided by 3. This will be minus 70 by 3 because 120 is the greater number. So you will get minus 35 divided by 3, that is the A value. Now since we got the A value, we can find out the 9th term of the AP by using the nth term formula. An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So substituting, N is equal to 9. So A9 is equal to, what is the A term? Minus 35 divided by 3 plus N is 9 minus 1 into D is again 5. A9 is equal to minus 35 divided by 3 plus 9 minus 1 is 8. 8 5s are 40. Again, if you take the LCM as 3, you get minus 35 here plus 4 3s are 12, that is 120. So minus 35 plus 120. How much is that? 120 and minus 35. So carrying, 10 minus 5 is 5. So 1 will be here. Again, if we carry 1, so 11 minus 3 is 8. It is 85. So it is 85 divided by 3. Therefore, A9 or the 9th term is 85 divided by 3. With A value, we got it as minus 35 divided by 3. So this is how we solve this problem. If you have any doubts, please comment me below in the comment section. In my next video, I'll be solving the second part of the question number 3 from question number 6 to 10. So till then, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.